I hope all of you are very well and fine at home. Let us start our next exercise. I thought exercise 4.1 and 4.2. Everything is clear to you. The solution of the equations. In exercise 4.1 and 4.2, we understand how we can develop an equation. What is the left hand side expression? What is the right hand side expression? Or how we can solve the equation using few steps. Like step 1 or step 2, how we can add, how we can subtract the constant so that we get the value of the variable. Alright, the next exercise is exercise 4.3. In this exercise, we have to solve the following equation. Now, it is not written that you must write down the steps, but the method you must follow. Alright, either it is written that solve the equation means the simpler way you have to find out the value of the variable. So let us start with first question. Understand, you must do first of all first question, all parts of the first question. Alright, first question is 2y plus 5 by 2 is equal to 37 by 2. This is the question we have to solve. Now what are the steps we have to follow? We want to eliminate 5 by 2 and 2 from the left hand side so that we get the value of the variable only. Alright, so we have to follow step by step. Before we want to eliminate 2, the first step we have to eliminate the constant which is present in the addition or in the subtraction. Like 5 by 2 present in the addition. Alright, now we want to eliminate 5 by 2 from the left hand side. What we have to do? We have to subtract 5 by 2 from both the sides. Alright, we must follow, the process must be in both the sides. So, 2y plus 5 by 2 minus 5 by 2 in left hand side. 37 by 2 minus 5 by 2 in the right hand side. So, minus 5 by 2 in the left hand side and minus 5 by 2 in the right hand side. This is the first step. But in this question, it is not important that you every time write step 1, step 2, follow the same step. But the name step 1, step 2 is not important to write. Steps are as usual. Alright, so now when we subtract 5 by 2 from the left hand side, the plus term is cancelled out with the similar minus term. So that you get 2y in the left hand side. Now what about the right hand side? 37 by 2 minus 5 by 2. See here, you can take the LCM 2. So 37 minus 5, what we get? 32 by 2. When we cancel out this, we get 16. So overall, after first step, we get the equation is 2y is equal to 16. Now, divide both sides by 2. Why we divide? Because 2 is present in the multiplication and we want to eliminate 2, and the opposite of multiplication is division. So divide both sides by 2. So 2y divided by 2, 16 by 2. When we solve these two terms, 2 is cancelled out with 2, so that 2 is also eliminated from the left hand side. So we are using two steps. One is related to addition or subtraction. Second related to multiply or division. So we get y is equal to 8. This is the solution of the equation. As we understand in previous video, now we can check that this is answer is correct or not. How we can check? We can put the value of the y in the given question, in the given equation. If equation is satisfied, means the left hand side after putting the value y is equal to right hand side, we get that this is the solution of the equation. Alright, now come towards its one more method to solve the similar equation. I will write the same question in both the sides. To understand, there is one more method. By using that method also, you can solve the equations. Now that method is called transposing method. Transpose means you have to give a transfer to one number. That is, change the side of the number. Means if some number is present in the left hand side, after transposing, that number move towards the right hand side. Now this process, that is transposing, only in respect of addition or subtraction, not in the respect of multiply or division. So in place of subtraction or addition, we can use the word transpose. Alright, first of all, understand the method. Then I told you about the difference of these two methods. Now, in this method, now the first step we have to follow, transpose 5 by 2 from left hand side to the right hand side. Here 5 by 2 is present in the left hand side. Our main motive is to eliminate these two constants, that we have to do at any cost. Alright, either by these steps or by second method, we just eliminate both the constants. Now, transpose 5 by 2 from left hand side to the right hand side. Now, when we want to transpose, now it is not important that you write addition or subtraction. Now, in transpose means you understand, it is understandable that when 5 by 2 is transposed towards right hand side, its sign always change. When it is with plus sign in the left hand side, when it transposes to the right hand side, its signs are negative. So see here, the next step, 2y is equal to 37 by 2 minus 5 by 2. Alright, so when we want direct transpose of a constant from one side to another side, its sign always change. So its sign change plus to minus. Alright, but what is the difference in these two methods? You can see here, when we solve this equation on this side, again the LCM is similar and we get overall is 16. Now, see, this equation we get after first step, after transposing, and the same equation we get after first step. So the overall motive is similar. We want to eliminate the constant. But the basic difference in these two, here we write subtract 5 by 2 from both the sides. Alright, so we must represent the 5 by 2 with subtraction in both the sides. Alright, but here there is no need to write 5 by 2 in both the sides. You just transpose, that is, only this side is represented. Like this, we are not going to important to write. Just pick 5 by 2 from left hand side and place in the right hand side. But both, the purpose of both methods are similar. Alright, only the difference is a little bit that there is no need to write 5 by 2 again in the left hand side. It directly transfer or transpose to the right hand side. But overall the solution is similar. Now, what is the next step? Divide both sides by 2. Same step we have to follow here. Because transpose is only used for either addition or the subtraction, not for the multiplication or the division. So now, divide both sides by 2 in the similar way. When we divide both sides, this 2 is cancelled out with this 2. We get y is equal to 8. So this is the solution as we have understand here. So the basic difference, the basic of both the equations, both the methods are similar. Only the written portion or just for the one step, you must understand, is different. Now you can use both the method, any method to solve the equation. But if it is written that you must use transpose method, that you have to use. But it is not compulsory to use. You can use this method or this method. Both are the similar method to solve the constant. Alright, now the next question, let us understand the C part of this equation, because these are the similar question, just the method I told you. A divided by 5 plus 3 is equal to 2. Let us do this question only by transposing method. Only by transposing method. What the method told here? In this question, we just use only transposing method. You can adopt any method. It is not important that you have to use. The question is a divided by 5 plus 3 is equal to 2. Now, we have to solve the equation. What is the purpose to solve? Just eliminate both the constant from left-hand side and we are only leaving with the variable in left-hand side. The sum changes happen in the right-hand side as well. That is for the balancing of the equation. So, the first step, transpose 3 from left-hand side to right-hand side. Alright, from left-hand side to right-hand side. This step is a divided by 5 is equal to 2 minus 3. Now understand here, there is no need to write 3 again in the left-hand side. We are going to transpose this. When we transpose, then the sign change. Plus is changed into subtraction. Alright, as we have done that, the similar process is for this. So what we get here? We get minus 1. So overall equation is now a by 5 is equal to minus 1. But for multiplication division, we have to follow the same step. Now 5 present in division. So opposite of this, multiply both sides by 5. So what we get here? A divided by 5 multiplied 5 minus 1 multiplied 5. 5 is cancelled out. So all constants are eliminated. Only A is equal to minus 5. Alright students, I want to understand how the both methods use. But the basic motto is similar. We want to eliminate the constant. But this transpose method, always remember, only used for addition or subtraction. Use at that place, not for. We can also use first method or second method as your wish. But I want to tell you both the methods. You can adopt any method. Now you have to complete your exercise 4.3, only first question. All parts of first question. In next video, I just give you brief introduction of the other question. Only then you can solve. Alright, friends. Thank you.